Good morning. Welcome to our celebration of the Eucharist. Please join us in singing our opening hymn, Sing a New Song.
Sing a new song unto the Lord. Let your song be sung from mountains high. Sing a new song unto the Lord. Sing alleluia. Shout and gladness, dance for joy. Oh, come before the Lord and play for God on glad tambourines. Let your trumpet sound.
Good morning, everyone.
Good morning, Father.
Today, we shall have two intentions for this Mass. We shall be praying for the peaceful repose of the soul of Arnold Carlos, and also for the peaceful repose of Leola Lutomsky. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Dear brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Grant us, we pray, O Lord our God, constant gladness of being devoted to you, for it is full and lasting happiness to serve with constancy the author of all that is good. Through our Lord, Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
This is a reading from the prophet Ezekiel. Our God says, I, myself, will take care of my sheep. As a shepherd watches over the flock, so I will watch over my sheep. I, myself, will feed them and give them rest. I will find those who are lost and bring them back. I will heal those who are hurt. I will be a good shepherd to my sheep. But remember, I will judge between one sheep and another, and I will judge between the sheep and the goats. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Shepherd, your hand is with me. are my shepherd,
you are my friend. I want to follow you always, just to follow my friend. When pathways are dark, you are there guiding me, keeping me safe.
You are my shepherd. My shepherd,
you are
my friend. I want to
follow you always,
just to follow my friend.
You give me to eat, you make me feel welcome, you fill me with joy.
You are
shepherd, you are my friend. I want to follow you always,
just to follow my friend.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, when the King comes in glory, he will sit on his throne with all the angels around him. All the people of the world will come to him, and he'll separate them, just like a shepherd separates the sheep from the goats. Then the king will say to the sheep, come and receive your share of the kingdom, which I have prepared for you. For when I was hungry, you gave me food. When I was thirsty, you gave me a drink. When I was a stranger, you made me feel welcome. When I had nothing to wear, you gave me clothes. When I was sick, you took care of me. And when I was in prison, you came and visited me. The people who hear these words will ask, when did we see you hungry and give you food? When did we see you thirsty and give you a drink? When did we take you in and make you feel welcome? When did we give you clothes to wear? When did we see you sick or in prison and come to visit you? And the king will answer, when you do those things for any of my brothers and sisters in need, you do it to me. And those who do these things will live with God forever. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Good morning, my dear children. Good morning, my dear children.
Good morning.
That's better. That's better. I think I'm the one feeling a little bit too cold because I'm not too used to the cold. Not so. You should be used to the cold already. So how's it been? Everybody good? Everybody good?
Yes.
Oh, good, good. So can we give a thumb up to that? Good. Some people are taking two. That's wonderful. Means we are all good. Today, we have listened to the readings. I will just wish to find out, as usual, let's try to find out what we heard. What did we hear today? Can we begin this way and we'll go to... Yes? Jesus tells us that if you help somebody in need, you are helping Jesus. Wow. Good. Wonderful. Yes? Yes, please. Come again. You give food and drink to those who are in need. Yes, yes. Good. Wonderful. That God is present in everyone. Yes. That God helps everybody. Good. Yes. Be an image of God. Yes. Louder. Can we get you? Everybody has God in him, and if you help anybody, you are actually helping God. Yes, please. If you're helping those in need, God will actually, you know, acknowledge the fact that you're helping him. Yes, please. Yes, you. Good, he will separate the sheep from the goats in relation to the right or wrong. Those who do right are going to be with him. Those who do not do right are not going to be. That's good.
Everybody
Everybody has their talent, yes, to help. Yes, the ability to help. That you should. You should do the corporal works of mercy to everybody. Beautiful. Whenever you help others, you go closer to God. Beautiful. Yes, please. Everybody is created in the image of God, in God's image. Wow. Do we have to say anything again? Do we have to say anything again? You guys are just wonderful. Can you clap for yourselves? You are just wonderful. Wow. 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 Which means that we were actually attentive when the readings were going on. Next week, we are going to celebrate the feast of Christ the King. Jesus Christ, who is King, is calling on us, his children, to show love to one another. That the only way we can tell him we love him is by showing love to one another. So, if Jesus Christ is telling us that we can only show love to him by showing love to one another, so what does he expect of us? What does he want us to do in a bit to show that love for him? Yes, please. Show love to others, yes. Care for one another, yes. Help others in need, yes. Treat others the way you want to be treated. Anybody here? Yes, I see a hand up. Be fair to others. Yes. To respect others. Yes. Good. I didn't get come again. Feed the poor and shelter the homeless. Yes. Say things with kindness and love to other people. Yes. Welcome people. Jesus tells us that we should be able to welcome strangers. Not so. Yes. To be kind. Yes. Help people who are sick. To be the best version of yourself. Wonderful. Clothe the naked. And we take the last two there. Yes, the last two. Pray for others. Yes. Yes, please. Those people who are near, treat those who are... Yes, I'll take the last. Your hand was up. Yes. Could you speak loud? I'm not getting you. Welcome everybody who comes around. I think what Jesus is calling us to do today is to show love to one another. If we remember, Jesus asks us to love our neighbors as ourselves. Not so. Yes, it is in loving that we make Christ present wherever we find ourselves. There is something I appreciate, and I talked about it last week when we were talking about talents. Those who do ushering in the morning and after school. Are there some ushers in this class? Can they raise their hands up? Good. Can we clap for them? You are just doing what Jesus Christ is asking you to do, to show love to your brothers and sisters, your friends in class, your friends in school, those with whom you are attending school. It's not easy to come up in the morning in the cold and you have to come and open the doors for all those who are coming to school. Not so. That's a holy duty you are doing. On the last day, Jesus is going to tell you, good and faithful servant, for doing your work and doing it well. So love is the one thing that Jesus Christ is calling us as his children to have for one another. There are those who are in need and who need our love. It is in loving, and we can only show that love to others or to God when we show it to one another. Do we see God? Can you see God? Can you see God? Where is God? In other people. Wonderful. God is found in other people. All of us, as we are seated here today, we are created in the image and likeness of God, which means
God lives in each and every one of us. So if I want to tell God I love you, who should I say this to? Who should I say this to? Yes, please. Say it to everyone. So can you tell the person sitting beside you, I love you? Tell the person beside you, I love you. When you say you love them, then you are saying you love God, okay? Because God lives in them. When you treat them well, you are treating God well. And if you don't treat them well, it means you are not treating God. God is asking us to show love to one another. So today, when we go back home and when we close from school, what is going to be our language today? Yes, please. You tell everybody you love them. Beginning from who? Yes? The person right beside, please clap for him. That's just awesome. That's just awesome. The person right beside you. I think Prince of Peace School today, we have just one thing to tell everybody we meet. Our friends in class, those who sit beside us, our teachers, our parents particularly, we remember they are doing a lot for us, not so. When they come to pick us up today from school, your first word should be, "Good afternoon, Daddy, I love you." Okay? And that same love that we express by talking, we should be able to show it by our actions to those around us. Those who are opening the doors, those who are helping others with their bags after school, those who are helping their teachers, those who are helping their parents back at home. In doing all of that, we show love. That is the love God is asking us to have. That is the love Jesus Christ is asking us to have. So as we remember him as our King, the one assignment we must do, such that we too can hear at the end, "Good and faithful servant, you have done well," is for us to show love. So, can you tell the person beside you, "I love you" again? Can you say, "I love you" again?
I love you.
And I also love you all. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
As brothers and sisters living in love, let us turn to God with our needs and our prayers.
For the Catholic Church, that she continues to show how central Christ is to all, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our Eucharistic community, that we may strive to relieve the hunger and injustice of our world, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of us, that we may recognize Christ in others and treat them with love and kindness, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have died, that the Good Shepherd may lead them to the heavenly kingdom, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all the intentions and prayers in our hearts, both spoken and unspoken, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Our Mother Mary continues to intercede for us when we pray. Hail Mary,
full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
All these prayers we make through Christ your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
Our presentation hymn is "You Are Near."
we are many parts.
We are many parts. We are all one body. And the gifts we
brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Grant, O Lord, we pray, that what we offer in the sight of your majesty may obtain for us the grace of being devoted to you and gain us the prize of everlasting happiness. Through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
Your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For although you have no need of our praise, yet our thanksgiving is itself your gift. Since our praises add nothing to your greatness, but profit us for salvation through Christ our Lord. And so, in company with the choirs of angels, we praise you and with joy we proclaim.
Holy, holy, holy.
Indeed, holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness, make holy therefore these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that we may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you've held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Stephen, our bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that we, the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, our chaste spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen, 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 amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
With a wave and as a sign of our love for one another, let us extend a sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of Lamb of God, you take away
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Our communion hymn is "You Are Near."
Thank you.
standing always at my side. You guard me from the foe, and you lead me in ways everlasting.
Let us pray. We have partaken of the gifts of the sacred mystery, humbly imploring, O Lord, that what your Son commanded us to do in memory of him may bring us growth in charity. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down upon you and remain with you forever.
Amen.
Go forth, the Mass is ended.
Thanks be to God.
Our closing hymn is the Prince of Peace song.
You are holy.
You are holy.
You are mighty.
You are mighty.
You are worthy.
You are worthy.
Worthy of praise.
Worthy of praise.
And I will follow.
And I will follow.
And I will listen.
And I will listen.
And I will love you.
And I will love you.
All of my days.
All of my days.
You are the Lord of lords. You are the King of kings. You are the mighty God, Lord of everything. You're Emmanuel, you're the great I am. You're the Prince of Peace, and I will live my life for you.
Little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine.